When I say AC, it not only means alternating current, it also means alternating voltage. Second point is, direct current flows only in one direction, whereas alternating current flows in two directions. Why generation of AC is efficient than DC? Let's first try to generate the AC. Now, from this I can make two different points. My sixth point would be,
before we start with the difference between AC and DC, I'll strongly recommend you to watch my previous videos on AC and DC, in which I have explained about the basics. You'll get link for those videos down in the description. Already done watching those videos? Then let's move on with the difference between AC and DC. As the name suggests, alternating current changes its direction and magnitude with time. This is what we have learned in the alternating current video. So if you draw the waveform, it will look like this. In similar way, direct current or DC does not change its direction or magnitude with time. It remains constant. So if you draw the waveform, it will look like this. So this is our first difference. One thing I would like to highlight here is that when I say AC, it not only means alternating current, it also means alternating voltage. Basically, AC is a common term used to indicate anything that alternate with time, which indicates voltage and current both, because we also say AC voltage. Similarly, when we say DC or steady current, it means anything that remains steady or constant with time, which includes voltage and current both. We also say DC voltage. Second point is, direct current flows only in one direction, whereas alternating current flows in two direction. This you can conclude from waveforms. Now when I say two direction, I mean positive and negative. If you look at the waveform of DC, it is always in positive side. Whereas in AC, half portion is in positive side and half is in negative side. Third point is, we can generate DC by using DC generators, batteries and solar panels. Also, rectifiers converts AC into DC. To produce AC, we need to use alternator. Also, inverter can convert stored DC into AC. Now let's look at some of the applications of AC and DC as fourth point. DC power is widely used in low voltage applications such as charging batteries, automotive application, aircraft application, and other low voltage, low current applications. Whereas AC power is used for generation, transmission, and distribution. AC is also used to power the houses, different types of buildings, etc. With AC, it is possible to build electric generators, motors, and power transmission and distribution systems, which are way too efficient than DC. DC is also sometimes used for power transmission, but it is not that efficient. Now the question is, why this is so? Why AC is efficient than DC? First, let's look at why generation of AC is efficient than DC. Let's first try to generate the AC. Let's say we have a machine which has a permanent magnet with N and S pole. Between these two poles, one coil is rotating with the help of some external force, maybe a motor. Now let's draw a waveform for voltage produced by this machine. When the coil is in position A, voltage across the coil is 0. When the position of coil changes to B, maximum voltage will be generated across the coil. When the coil goes to the position C, again the voltage becomes 0. When the coil goes to the position D, again the voltage becomes maximum but in the opposite direction. And in the next position, it gets to 0 again. And this complete process will repeat. So that's how we generate AC, and it is simple too. Now let's look at the construction of DC generator. It may sound irrelevant, but to generate DC, we have to generate AC first and then convert it into DC. And this is the reason why construction of DC generator is complicated and costlier. So why it is complicated and costly? Let's look into that. The process to generate DC is same till the generation of AC. After that, we need to convert the AC into DC. Basically, to make this DC, we have to stop voltage from changing the direction. And we can do that by using a component called as commutator. With commutator, we need to also add two stationary carbon brushes which makes the contact with external load as shown in the figure. What commutator does is that every time the polarity is about to change, it makes the brushes to change their position, and hence we get a voltage with a constant polarity. The voltage will vary or pulsate but will never change the direction. But as we are making the brushes change their position every time, it causes sparking and heat, which is very obvious. If we make the coil rotate faster, the problem of sparking and heating will increase further. Also, to get the smoother waveform, we need to add more coils to the machine. This makes the construction of DC generator complex and costlier, and hence generation of AC is very cheaper and efficient than DC. Construction of AC motor and DC motor are similar to their generator counterparts. I'll say it is identical. DC motor requires brushes to make the contacts, AC motor do not. This makes the AC motor more cheaper than the DC motor. So my fifth point would be, generation of AC is cheaper and easy, whereas generation of DC is costlier and complex than AC. Now I could have told you this point directly without telling the reason behind it, but that makes remembering that point a little difficult. But when you know reason behind something, you remember it forever. And that's the reason why I'm telling you the reason behind every difference. There is an effect in electromagnetism called as mutual induction. What happens is, when we place two coils near to each other, out of which one coil is carrying AC, this will create AC voltage in other coils. This is the principle on which transformer works. Using the device called as transformer, we can step up or step down the AC voltage. When transmitting electrical power to a long distance, it is advantageous and efficient to do so with stepped up voltage. Further, this stepped up voltage can be stepped down after the transmission phase and then can be delivered to the different consumers. This advantage of AC cannot be matched by DC. This useful device transformer can only work with AC and not DC, because the principle of working of transformer is based on the mutual induction, which is possible with changing magnetic field, and DC can only produce steady magnetic field. Now, from this I can make two different points. My sixth point would be, AC can be stepped up or stepped down using a transformer, whereas DC cannot be stepped up or stepped down. My seventh point would be, transmission of AC is cheaper, whereas transmission of DC is costlier and complex than AC. If you observe the waveform of AC, you will find that there is a one set of positive values and one set of negative values. If you combine these two sets, it becomes a cycle. And number of such cycle that occurs in 1 second is called as frequency. In AC, it is generally 50 or 60. In DC, there is no concept called as frequency, as the waveform does not change the direction. So the eighth point would be, frequency of AC is 50 or 60 Hz. Hertz is the unit of frequency. Whereas in DC, there is no concept called as frequency. These are the few differences between AC and DC. Now I have prepared a summary slide for you. You can pause this video and read all this point again, or just take a snapshot and read it whenever you want. If you know any other different than this, do let me know via comments. I'll be happy to read those. If you like the video, do hit the like button and share it with your friends as well. That's all for this video, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.